I'm Ritwik Rai, analyst for media sector at Kotak Securities, and I'm here to give you a brief on the media sector in the coming few months. Broadly, in the media sector, we think there are three factors that will affect the sector in the coming months. Firstly, of course, being the advertising expenditures. On advertising expenditures, we think that the slowdown that is apparent in advertising shall continue for advertising expenditures by firms shall continue for the next few months, maybe at least the next two quarters or so. The key categories that have witnessed slowdown are unlikely to come back in a hurry. So we would think that for at least for the first half of this the coming calendar year, we are likely to see sub-trend advertising expenditure growth. The as per the trend relation with the GDP, it should be 4 percentage points above the nominal GDP growth, and we would expect it to be substantially below that. So we'd expect the advertising expenditures growth to be only in the range of high single digit in the next few quarters. The second factor that we'd like to draw your attention to is the depreciation of the Indian rupee and impact on the media sector. The impact shall be felt primarily by newspaper publishers, and especially those newspaper publishers that are exposed to a higher imported newsprint requirement. Thirdly, the third factor is digitization, and the Parliament has approved the amendments in the Cable Act, and accordingly, digitization might take off in the coming few months. The metro's digitization could be as early as June 2012. We think this could be a big game changer, but the issue here is that what kind of gains could accrue to various subsectors, that is between digitization, between distributors and broadcasters, is quite uncertain. And to that extent, while this could be a big game changer, one can only look at it as an incremental factor as of now. Broadly, we'd like to continue playing the media sector based on our prior theme, which is monetization. So we'd continue to hold a preference for stocks that are either market share gainers or market share leaders by far. In terms of market share gainers, we continue to like HT Media, and the company has continually shown strong leadership trends in three of its key properties, which are in its biggest markets, that is Mumbai, in Hindustan, and in Mint. And the stock is available quite cheaply now after declines that we've seen. So the stock is available at about 12 to 13 times earnings, FY12. Even if one were to consider the impact of higher newsprint expenses that could come in because of the rupee depreciation, we think there could be a downside of up to 10 to 15% to our estimates in terms of FY13 EPS estimates. And so we think that even looked at in terms of FY13, the stock is quite cheap, and we see a long-term story here. Our second pick, which is for the slightly more for the investors who have a slightly higher risk appetite, it's Sun TV Network, which we think is trading quite cheaply. The company has shown a significant amount of resilience to the political pressures that have been seen in Tamil Nadu. That is quite apparent from the second quarter results. We expect earnings of about 22 rupees for this year, so the stock is quite available quite cheaply again, even by historical standards. And the company continues to hold very strong ground in Tamil Nadu, which is completely dominated by Sun TV, also in Karnataka and in Andhra Pradesh. So we have a preference for these two stocks in terms of our top sell. Zee Entertainment continues to be our top sell. The company's key channel, that is the ZTV, which is a Hindi GEC channel, continues to face strong competition headwinds. So the company's channel, that is ZTV, has fallen to number 4, and if trends were an indication, then it's likely to stay there. So competition has heated up there. Star India has also launched a new channel in the Hindi GEC space, so competitive intensity is unlikely to reduce. In other spaces as well, that is in other genres like in Marathi or in Bengali, we see Aziz's situation weakening quite a bit. And so we think the stock is somewhat expensive at over 19 times earnings FY12 or FY13. We think ZTV's Zee Entertainment's earnings are likely to stay stagnant for the period FY11 to FY13. So our top picks would be Sun TV and HT Media, depending on the risk appetite, and our top sell would be Zee Entertainment. Thank you.